Hi, I'm Matt Lewis with Hagerty. In today's DIY, we're going to talk about different ways to connect wires and why you would use them. So for today's demonstration, I'm going to introduce you to some of my favorite tools. This one right here are wire strippers, auto strippers. And this is a nice set of crimpers designed for crimping butt connectors and different types of connectors. Finally, we have a more standard wire stripper. I don't like these as much as the auto stripper, but they do a fine job. Personally, I like these better. So we'll set those aside. Now, to start off with any wire connection, what you're gonna wanna do is make sure you have some bare wire showing. Now, especially if you're working on an older car, you wanna make sure that this bare wire is shiny and clean. Oftentimes you'll see corrosion and that sort of thing, and that can actually add resistance to the circuit. And may cause things to not function properly. In order to connect these two, something I always like to do with wires is just give them a twist. It helps keep these strands of this stranded wire bunched together, and it makes it a little neater when you're going to connect them. So we'll do the same with our red wire. First way we're going to connect these two wires is with a barrel connector, or butt connector, as I've heard them called. These are little plastic connectors where on the inside there's a metal tube, essentially, and that metal tube is what connects the two wires. You can see this metal tube has a split down the middle. That's something to keep in mind. You're going to want to orient yourself with that split. So we'll take our first wire, we'll run it in, being careful that the shielding of the wire extends inside of our connector here. We know we have that done well, so what we're going to do is I like to take, as you can see, there's the split here on this top. I like to have that facing away so that when we use our crimper, we're placing that in the cup or the bottom. So you can see where it is here on the bottom. And then when we crimp down, we make a good strong grab of that wire. Now we're gonna do the same thing with our second blue side. Slide this inside of here, again, making sure that the shielding on the wire extends inside of this connector, and crimping it down like we did with the red. This makes a nice strong connection that's just fine for a lot of applications. This style of connection connects these two wires fairly well electrically. Where these don't work as well is in an environment that might get wet outside of the car, under the car, in the engine bay. I don't like these as much because moisture and water can get inside and start to corrode this connection. So these definitely work well inside of the cab if you're wiring up a stereo, that sort of thing, but I'd avoid using them anywhere that moisture could really get to them. If you would like to use a barrel connector somewhere that's susceptible to moisture, they do make special ones that have heat shrink tube on the outside. So you would connect these the exact same way we did the other one with our nice crimper tool. Now that this connection's made, you can use a lighter, you can use a heat gun. I have a little special tool here. So this is just a very small butane style soldering iron that came with a tip specifically for heat shrink. And so we'll just wrap it around. Now the heat from this will shrink down this external tube. And as you can see now, this side is right up against the shielding of this wire, not allowing any moisture inside of our connection. This is going to be a better situation for sealing up this connection than your just normal plastic style that doesn't shrink down at all. So this would be okay to use under the hood, underneath the car, somewhere that's susceptible to moisture because it seals off this end of the wire. Now, you can buy kits of different types of connectors. This one here, and then this is a much nicer that has the shrink style connector on it. We'll talk about those in a minute. You can get these at local hardware stores, at auto parts stores, that sort of thing, and it's nice to have a variety of connectors. So I like to keep a couple of kits with me. So let's say we want to hook up to something like a switch. Here I've got a pretty standard automotive switch with these spade style terminals on the back. They make specific connectors just to hook to those. This first one here is a non-shielded connector. As you can see, the end is just bare metal. And then the same thing with a shielded end. So if you're worried about the switch location and it shorting out or hitting ground or running into other wires, you're going to want to run the shielded one to kind of protect that circuit. If you're not worried about it at all, this fellow will do just fine. So you don't have to have a nice set of wire strippers like these in order to work with the electrical, but I really like these. It gives you a very accurate means by which to strip this wire. Depending on where you place it, is how much wire is removed. You want to remove about a quarter inch of shielding when you're working with a connector like this. And as I did before, twist it up, and then make sure it extends far enough in that your shielding is inside the shielding on the connector and your wire is extending into the actual terminal section of the connector. And with our shielded connector, if you're worried about shorting out and that sort of thing, it's the exact same deal. Insert the wire so that the shield is inside of the shield of the connector. Take our crimper and crimp down. And now, simply attach it to the connection. Now, you may be wanting to connect to a post style terminal like this ignition coil has. And what you're going to want to do with those is what's called a ring terminal. These ring terminals come in a few different sizes. Not only are they different sizes for the gauge of the wire that you're working on, small, medium, large, and these colors correspond to the gauge, but also the size of the ring that you're working with. So you want to make sure that it's not too big and sloppy on the ring, but it also needs to fit over. So we're going to go ahead and select this medium red style terminal. Just like before, we'll twist up our wire, slide the terminal over it, give it a nice crimp, and we're going to be able to fit this down over, put our washer back in place, when you tighten down your nut, now you have a nice connection from your wire to your stud. So if you don't have good space to be working with a ring terminal, you do have a few other options. There's this hook style terminal, and then there's this fork style terminal. And these are useful if you can't get the nut all the way off, or it's the type of connector that doesn't come all the way up. It needs to go under a screw. And what you would do is connect onto this, and then you can simply slide that onto your stud and tighten down, which would make a decent connection. Or like with this hook one, you can get it underneath. That way, if this wire does get pulled on, it's still gonna hold. So for our final connection type, we're gonna be soldering. So here I've got a brand new soldering iron right from the auto parts store. Cost about $5. Comes with a nice little metal stand because it's gonna get super hot. And then you just plug it into the wall and wait until it's hot enough to start melting the solder. It usually takes about 5 to 10 minutes. Go ahead and just apply some to the tip. You can see, yes, it's melting on there nice. You got a nice little bit of smoke. So we're ready to start soldering wires. The solder I've brought today is a 60-40 mix. This is 60% tin, 40% lead, and it is a rosin core solder. They make acid core solder, but you don't want to use that. That's more for like stained glass work. Electrical work, you almost always want to use rosin core solder. So we'll go ahead and take our two wires. Strip them back. You can strip it a little bit more than normal on this one. And then I like to twist these two together. Make sure they're nice and twisted. And you want to make sure you have good penetration of the solder into the wires. A good way I've found to do that is if you heat the back side of the wire and kind of feed it in to the back of the wire, you'll see it soak in and start to take the shape of that twisted wire. If it's nice and shiny and it's taken the shape of the wire, that's going to be a nice, good, strong connection for these two wires. You can see they're really held together with this solder. To finish it off, once this has cooled down a little bit, what we'll do, we'll put our shrink tube, make sure to completely cover the exposed wire. And we'll go ahead and use our nice little shrink tube tool. So as you can see with our connector now, The bare wire is completely covered by a shrink tube. It has been soldered together, and this is a very strong connection, both electrically and physically. You can't really pull them apart. This is the best scenario, in my opinion, for connecting two wires together. But if you don't have the space, you don't have the tools, you can use these different butt-style connectors to get the same job done. Now, you may find yourself in a situation where you need to plug in and unplug a circuit, whether it's a temporary light bar or maybe an external speaker for hooking up to your car. And what they make for that type of thing is this bullet connector. And these are nice because they still make a good connection, just like our barrel connector did, to the wire. The benefit of this is you can then plug in when you need it, then when you don't, you can unplug it. So if it's something that you're taking in and out of the car that needs to be temporary, this is a great solution. If you'd like to learn more about soldering and get a little more in-depth information, be sure to subscribe to our channel. We're gonna have a specific solder DIY video coming out soon. And if you have any questions or comments, please leave them in the section below and subscribe to our channel so you can see the next video.